Many pardons, my lord, but are you not Sir Alistair Sarwick? I heard tell that you had returned to the Seven Kingdoms.
Indeed. You appear to know much about me. To whom do I have the honor of speaking?
I realize that my impromptu intervention might have startled you, my lord, but pray, do not take umbrage. The return of a war hero could not help but attract my attention, particularly when his return proves to be so ostentatious.
I won no honors in the war, just scars. But you have yet to introduce yourself.
Your modesty does you honor, my lord. You forged quite a name for yourself fighting for King Robert in his rebellion. Excuse my rudeness. I've not yet told you my name. I am Lord Varys, and I hope you will count me as a friend. We never crossed paths 15 years ago, but perhaps you have heard of me?
Lord Varys. Oh yes, I know you. You were master of whisperers to old King Aerys Targaryen. I did not recognize you, disguised as you are. I remember a more elegant man of the court.
Well, I am delighted to hear that. Let us simply say that I sometimes prefer to go unnoticed.
You haven't changed. Already in the time of Aerys, it was said that you had eyes in every court in Westeros, and that you knew everything about everyone. We rebels called you the Spider. Some of our lords were wary of you. You made some enemies along the way.
Alas, the people of the Seven Kingdoms have little affection for eunuchs. All of those noble knights and grand lords are loath to risk their reputations with informers and spies. But in the Game of Thrones, information is power. Those who most despise us are often the first to benefit from our whispers.
You, who were loyal to House Targaryen. I had thought that you would have fallen with King Aerys.
My loyalty is to the crown, Sir Alistair, not to he who wears it. The moment that Robert Baratheon sat upon the Iron Throne, my duty was to assist him.
And he agreed to it. I hadn't thought that King Robert was a great friend to eunuchs and spiders.
Oh, he is not, my lord, as the gods are my witness. But it is in his nature to pardon defeated enemies who pay him homage, and that is to his great credit. Thus I kept my role as Master of Whispers, as well as my seat on the King's Council.
You must be a very busy man then, Lord Varys. I imagine that it is not coincidence that brings you to speak with me.
You are correct, my lord. I wanted to discuss the Baratheon Rebellion.
Why not? There is one question that I have never been able to be free of. Do you believe that the rebellion was a good thing, after all is said and done? Is King Baratheon a better king than Targaryen?
Old King Aerys was mad, my lord. Mad and cruel. That no one can deny. His habit of burning the great people of the kingdom alive could only bring him to ruin. After that, any idiot could have passed for a good king. As for His Majesty, Robert, his subjects loved him. Of that I have little doubt. But he pays little heed to matters of the realm and remains blind to the enemies around him. I fear that a new storm brews on the horizon. Does that knowledge make you regret your part in the rebellion?
No. The causes and consequences of the war mattered little to me at the time. My only concern was to obey Tywin Lannister, my liege lord. Had he ordered me to fight alongside the followers of Targaryen, I would have gone with him without hesitation.
I understand. You were just one young knight amongst hundreds of others, and Tywin Lannister was always a demanding master. He dragged you into that war and you carried out your duty as a bannerman.
At the time, Lord Tywin wanted a foot in each camp. When he ordered us to fight for Robert, I chose to follow his orders, yes.
Why such bitterness, my friend? You fought valiantly, and more importantly, you were on the winning side. You could have brought renown, fortune, and glory to your house, if you had so wished. And yet, when the time came to reap the benefits of your efforts, you turned away and left Westeros. I admit that I do not understand why.
The rebellion was not nearly as noble as it is portrayed in the tales and songs. You yourself know that. It is one thing to face an armed enemy. It is quite another to attack those who are already vanquished. Let us say that the last orders that I received left a bad taste in my mouth. I prefer to go. I did not want glory won in that manner.
It was a courageous decision, sir. It is often easy to forget that it is our choice whether or not to obey. Perhaps it would interest you to learn that your old squire, Valar, did not spurn the honors as you did. Lord Tywin Lannister covered him in gold and knighted him to reward him for his exploits and his unfailing loyalty.
For his unspeakable brutality, you mean to say? I had the opportunity to behold his work again in the square. Such a wild beast should not be left to roam free, much less granted a command. It is an invitation to disaster.
Have a care, my friend. Sir Valar has become an important member of the court. He is a faithful supporter of Queen Cersei's. And he could cause you great harm if you were to make him an enemy. I strongly recommend that you avoid making such remarks in public.
Valar is not only my old squire, he is also my half-brother. He may very well be as poisonous as an asp, but he cannot silence me. Not today, not ever.
I hope for your sake that you know what you're doing, my friend. Now, I'm afraid that I must beg your leave. Please excuse me. I'm afraid that my little birds are always chirping and demanding my attention. Make the most of your stay with Chattier. I hope to see you again soon.